when we talk about coaching, there is this very popular notion in our country that whoever goes to Delhi will be turn out to be a serious aspirant, will turn out to be a civil servant one day. But there are students from other states and people who are taking coaching in other places, they're also cracking the exam. So why do you think this notion has come up, and is there any authenticity connected to this?
See, actually it is like this. Maybe there was a time when Delhi developed as a hub for coaching centers, but the reality is, if from a A place 10,000 people are writing and 50 people crack the exam, it is okay. But imagine from a B place 1,000 people are writing and 20 people crack the exam. I say that B place is much greater than A place. So basically what happens is, in Delhi the number of students who go there is more, therefore you have high results. It is simple logic there. Having said this, the problem with Delhi is you have too many students in the class. You know, it is a very good corporate model where you have 500 to 600 students made to sit in one class. The teacher teaches, the students listen, but frankly, we don't know what they are able to follow. How personal mentorship is beyond doubt, because you will not be able to get access. And practically, even for a teacher, how many students will she manage when I have so many batches? And the second thing is, the weather in Delhi is very harsh. Many people not able to adjust to the weather come back. We have seen cases like that also. And it is undoubtedly very costly. The reality is, in Delhi, you have teachers from all over the country going and teaching. I mean, sizable number of teachers are also from the Telugu-speaking states. So we cannot say that Delhi is the best just because it has more results, which is because of more number of students. There are good alternatives developing. You have Hyderabad developing as a hub. Madras is developing. Bangalore is developing. So we do have other hubs also developing. I would specifically talk about Hyderabad, not just because I belong to that place, but I will talk about it because of two reasons. One is, the climatic conditions in Hyderabad are very, very friendly. You don't have extremities in weather. The second thing is, it is a very safe city, and it is comparatively a very economic city. You find accommodation and decent accommodation at a minimum price, with all kinds of food available. It's not that, you know, because it is in South India, you only get idli and sambar. In fact, I don't know if my people are aware, Hyderabad is a very cosmopolitan city. You have people from all over the country settled in Hyderabad, to the extent that you have a Gujarati gali, you have a Sindhi colony. So, you know, you have people from all over India. And that is the reason you find everything from momos to parathas, everything is available in Hyderabad. You will not face a food problem. It is easier to settle. And of course, there are many coaching centers which are picking up. They have less strength. They will be able to focus on you better, cater to you better. So, you know, you have hubs developing. It's not that you should depend on Delhi